Could you live off of $100 a week? I took on Meridian's spending challenge to see whether I could survive with $100 and still have fun in the city. On Monday mornings, I tend to sleep in. And because of this, I end up having to take a cab or rideshare to work. This week, I made sure to set up my alarm and I filled up my Presto card with enough money to get to and from work. I definitely saved a lot of money this way and it was a lot more efficient. After work on Monday, I went to the grocery store to pick up some fresh ingredients for lunch and dinner. This way, I saved a lot of money and I could eat healthy. On Tuesday, I decided to have a no-spend day. Now, this is key if you're looking to save money. I think it's a really good idea just to designate one day a week where you don't spend anything. This is a great way to automatically save money. So maybe if you think that you're gonna budget $20 or $30 of spending a day, you can actually put that money aside. And I mean, in a month, you already have $120. So I think this is a great idea. So Wednesday being hump day, I find I always need a cup of coffee to get through the day. And I do like the ritual of leaving the office and actually going to get a coffee from the nearby cafe. This time though, I decided to skip my flavored latte and go for a more economical iced coffee. These little spending tricks really help, you know, just still having the same lifestyle, but making more of those conscious choices. Thursday evenings usually means drinks with friends and maybe going out for dinner. This week though, we decided to pick up some pizza, grab some takeout, and buy a bottle of wine and just stay in. We definitely spent half of what we normally do. So it's Friday, we finally made it through the work week. I had about $15 left over, so I ended up going out to the movies, and I did not get popcorn this time. I think that is a key idea in saving, is to not waste money on those extras. By the end of the work week, I was amazed how far I could stretch $100. I ended up having a fun dinner with friends, I went to the movies, I got to and from work every day, and I had food for the entire week. One of my big realizations was to not waste money on cabs and rideshares. Living downtown for the first time, this is definitely one of the things I've fallen prey to, and I can see my bank statements and seeing all those rideshare receipts. So definitely cutting that out has helped me save a ton, and it's helped me stick to the $100 budget. Going forward, I'm gonna commit to having one no-spend day a week, whether that's in the middle of the week or maybe on a Sunday. I'm really gonna focus on sticking to that goal. I think putting that money aside or even just, you know, allocating it to other days is a really great idea, and it kind of makes you more conscious of your consuming habits. It's amazing how monitoring your spending can help you save for your goals, like a vacation or a down payment on a new condo. Thank you to Meridian for partnering with me on this video and for inspiring me to take on the spending challenge.